Hi, and welcome to this VRV video, which is designed to help you to transition from the DSIM 6300 sweep tester to the new ONX 630 sweep tester. This short video will help you in your transition by highlighting key points, such as how to turn on the device, how to access the sweep test options, how to run a forward sweep, how to run a reverse sweep, and finally, how to send test results into Stratasync. We turn on the ONX 630 device by pressing the green power button, which you can see being highlighted on the screen now. Here we can see the ONX 630 main screen. This is a touch screen, and so finding a way around the menus is pretty intuitive. We just simply select the arrows that you can see me tapping there now on the right hand side of the screen, and it opens up that menu that's available to us. Sweep testing can be found under the CATV network option. We can now see forward and reverse sweep options that are available. Simply select the test that you'd like to run and then hit enter or tap the screen to launch the test. DSIM 6300 users would launch sweep options from this screen, and typically we would see this type of results. Sweep testing can be found under the CATV network option. We can now see forward and reverse sweep options that are available. Simply select the test that you'd like to run and then hit enter or tap the screen. Now we're going to select the forward sweep test. As you can see, we select and then launch the forward sweep test, and we can see in here a couple of things. The first thing is that we're now in the absolute tab. You can see we have three tabs: absolute, referenced, and alignment. Within the absolute tab, you can also see that no reference has yet been set, but the test is running for forward sweep, and here we can see the frequencies and the levels for this particular test. First thing we might want to do is we might want to set up our markers. Let's say marker A, and you'll be able to see the frequency change here. Let's set it, say, to 91 megs. We'll now select marker B, and let's select that for 985 megs. So we've now set our markers A and B. Up here you can see confirmation of those frequencies, the levels, and the delta or difference between the two. The next thing we probably want to do is we probably want to save the test and set a reference. So I'm going to stop the test, at which point the configure option now becomes available, and under configure we can save this test that we're currently running. I'm now going to go and give this test a new name, and I'm going to call it test 5, and here we can see the date and time stamp that the test is automatically added, and select OK and save it. And now when I start the test, we'll see up here there's my test 5 with a date and time stamp on there. And there we can see the test is actually running. We can also see up here that this test has passed, and the reason it's passed is because it's comparing what the results are now to what we gave it as a reference. So if we go to the reference tab now, here's the results live that we're actually getting now relative to what our reference was. And here we can see a plus 2.5 dB trigger point for a failure and a minus 2.5 dB trigger test for a failure. I'm now going to stop the test, hit the home key, and go back to the home menu. DSIM 6300 users would launch sweep options from this screen, and typically we would see this type of results. Sweep testing can be found under the CATV network option. We can now see forward and reverse sweep options that are available. Simply select the test that you'd like to run and then hit enter or tap the screen. We select the reverse sweep option, the test will run, and the sweep results will be displayed on the screen, as you can see. Here we can see the reverse sweep test running and the results now being displayed on the screen. There's a couple of things we might want to do here. The first one is we might want to move the markers to help us to identify the frequency range and the difference on this peak that you can see on the screen. So if I highlight marker A and then use my cursor keys, you can see I can use my cursor keys to take me to one side of this incident. I then select marker B and do the same to the other side of the incident. And now we can see on the top that marker A is showing a frequency of 15 megs at about 20 dBs. Marker B is 13 megs at around 18 dBs, so a difference of around 2 dBs between the two. You could also notice that we're now looking at the absolute tab, but there are other tabs classed as referenced and alignments you can also see on the screen. And you can probably see there that we haven't yet set a reference for this particular test. The way we do this is pretty straightforward. We stop the test, at which time the configure option now becomes available. We go into the configure option and I would recommend saving a test and setting this particular test as a reference. So now I'm going to save the test as test 3, and you can see the tester will automatically date and timestamp this test and save it. And now when I start the test, you will see we now have the reference, which is our test 3 with a date and timestamp on it. And we will now also see that we have up here a pass, and this is a pass in compared to our reference. If we now go to the reference tab, we can see in here our current test results and also the plus 2.5 dB threshold for a failure and the minus 2.5 dB threshold failure. So this enables us to go to various places within our network to see how those values compare to our reference. Connecting to StratoSync is very easy. Simply select the StratoSync option that you can see highlighted on the screen. And you'll see when you go into StratoSync, you're asked for some details similar to the ones you can see on the screen now. The key ones being your StratoSync account ID and tech ID. Once you've confirmed these details are okay, and you only have to enter this once when you first get the tester, simply hit the start button and you can see now that I'm connecting now to StratoSync. This is normally done by my RJ45 cable into the side of the tester, but it could also be done on the cable network that you're working on. And as you can see now, we've had a successful sync, and that's it. Any files that were on the tester are uploaded into StratoSync. Any new options that you need configured adding to your tester are downloaded onto your tester. And any new firmware that's required on the tester would be mentioned at this time, and we can select to download that firmware. So a very simple process, I'm sure you'll agree.